Poro, Ricky Faikaha or Aotearoa, the first ever New Zealand Faikaha team to go up into England to play in the World Cup. Leading this team will be Harley Roach.
Growing up with a disability, was kind of told that we couldn't, we weren't able to do certain things in life. Just being a part of this and being with a bunch of fellas who's probably shared the same type of thing that I've been through in my life. And I want to thank my mum and my dad. I want to thank my wife and my six beautiful daughters who are back home in Christchurch for giving me this opportunity to come and represent our family, our country, and ourselves. Thank you very much.
Lovely.
His wife asked me to come along and referee, and I thought, okay, I don't even know the rules, but just put two and two together. When I turned up, it was clear to me that these players just want to contribute, want to participate, want to fulfill their dreams as rugby league players and just get out on the field. And my role has always been to facilitate a nice, clean, fun game. And it's always important to have a really good referee, because it just means that your game flows and you get a lot out of the game. And so that's my goal each time I take the field. For me, this type of rugby league is essential because we need to grow our game, the game that we love, in all aspects of our community. And to see PDRL players taking the field, especially on this international stage, is it has to be good for the game. It has to show those that have physical disability that they can contribute and that they can live their dreams. Just to see the looks on their faces each time they do the haka or stand when their national anthem is being sung is so important to all these players. And so, you know, it warms my heart to see members of our community, members of our society, being able to go hard out on the field.
I'm just playing for the entire country, the whole of New Zealand, every one of them.
My name is Laura Callahan. They asked me to help out with Phil because of my sign language and a few of the barriers that might happen within the matches. Just to really make sure that there's clear communication with the rules mainly. And just really to help with Phil whilst he's here in England. With the support for communication, really. Yeah, I'm really enjoying being part of the team. It's awesome.
Okay, Laura, so have you ever watched a rugby league game before?
Have I ever watched rugby league? I'm going to have to be truthful. No, I'm a little bit scared of rugby myself. We're a family that absolutely love football, so this is my first time with the team. And the first game that I watched was just fantastic. I was really shocked with some of the attacks and things that were happening with the physical disabilities. I'm really quite shocked with it all, and it's an amazing game, and I will be watching in the future.
So this is your first experience with any New Zealanders at all?
I have family that did move over to New Zealand. I'm very proud of them for doing that, and I see lots of photographs and I hear lots of amazing things about New Zealand, but now I understand why they're saying that. The culture and the differences and the family and the respect. It's just amazing. I'm loving the New Zealand, my new family.
But I met Sandra and we've continued to chat, and when we were talking about the Kiwis coming over, I wanted to give my support to them and rather than England, if I'm honest, because I knew that you guys would be coming over here with a small limited amount of funds, small limited amount of support, and I felt that, you know, myself and Lee would probably be able to fulfil some of those roles rather than pay for people to come over. My dad played rugby, my cousin played for the All Blacks, my brother played professional. I never played rugby in my life until I went to watch a game of PD, which was Warrington versus Wakefield, and I interviewed some of the lads, and while I was there, Craig Shepherd, who was managing, asked me if, you know, what my background was, and I was talking to another girl who got a spinal cord injury, and I said obviously I'd had the same in 2000, so I was paralysed temporarily and then lost all the sensation in my left leg. So he said, you can play. I was just like, don't be ridiculous, have you seen that? So he said, no, obviously when women play, they're in red shorts, it's touch tag only. So I thought, okay, I'll give it a training session. After that training session, they wouldn't let me leave. So I played my first game ever of rugby on the Halliwell Jones pitch, which is where we're going to be tomorrow night. I then became the first woman to play rugby league at Old Trafford, because myself and Lee went in 2019 to play there. My brother played 5 grand finals, so there was a lot of pressure on me to win, because he never lost. And that's it. That's my journey with rugby.
Oh, my name's Matthew Williams. I'm part of the Physical Disability Rugby League New Zealand team. I've been involved with it when I first started back in 2015 with Sandra Hickey, and yeah, I've really enjoyed it. Being involved with players that have the same, you know, have a disability, and we can all relate to that. Yeah, and I've really enjoyed it.
So how's it been this?
It's been great, except for the first day I got sick, so I was in bed for 3 nights. So apart from that, it's been really good.
You been on the fake room? Want to say it afterwards?
Sorry, boys, no lunch today.
No lunch.
You should be all right.
Kevin, you should have sent us up there. Kevin is about to fire us.
Yeah.
Why?
So, because we were his callers for scoring.
The stats.
For the stats, and Kevin
and Liam
Kevin
doesn't know
struggled.
Anything about, no, Liam doesn't know anything about rugby league. So really, it was a...
I think that we did very well.
No, we didn't.
I just think that Kevin wasn't quite up to understanding our language.
How about your son, how he played?
Do you know what? Maxie touched the ball a couple of times, pretty proud. Got a message from his dad, who was watching from home, saying, for God's sake, tell Max to stop going, ha! Each time the ref blows the whistle.
He's playing in there for the Kiwis.
That's exactly right, you know, and you can see the pride on all of their faces. It's brilliant.
Got the victory that they deserve. Well done, guys.
Yeah, so hi there, I'm Lee Whiteley, trainer, stroke, strength and conditioning coach, whatever you want to call me, assistant to Ray with the New Zealand PDRL team. Really, truly honoured to be part of the team and to be asked to be part of the team. To help out while you're over in the UK for the first PDRL World Cup. And so far the journey has been absolutely outstanding. We've had us ups, we've had us downs, but the guys are still smiling, so you know, we go on to the World Cup final in the first ever tournament. These lads, some of them have never played the game against physical disability players before, so it's literally their third, stroke fourth game, and the improvement that we've seen in such a short period of time has been fantastic. The guys are a great group, and it is truly, truly an honour to be part of that. Go Kiwis!
I think you just need to play your game. You're here in England representing. But we can beat them. We can. I've absolute faith in you. Okay?
Thanks,
Mikey. For everything, eh? Heads up, my bro. Heads up, man. Heads up. Not going to be sorry,
bro. You get yourself up to that third, that'd be class, pub.
All good, my bro.
Guys, great game. Great play there. Well done. You get yourself up there. Well done,
we did it. We did it. We got to the final.
Get you with a fine tooth comb. I was soft inside. There was something going on.
Come on, girls.
You did something to me that I can't explain. Hold me closer and I feel no pain.
Where's the girls?
Tender love is blind, it requires a dedication. All this love we feel needs no conversation. We ride it together, making love with each other, Islands in the stream, that is what we are. No one in between, how can we be wrong? Sail away with me to another world and live and die on each other. From one lover to another.
I just want to say it's been a fantastic, fantastic experience to be here with this bunch of athletes that are showcasing to the world their ability, not their disability. And you know, man, I couldn't have thought of a better place to be at this time. You know, I'm so proud of how they maintain themselves, how they present themselves to the public, and how they just welcome everybody into their space. You know, without these guys showing me how to behave, I wouldn't be the person that I am today. So yeah, I need to thank them, and I will thank them for allowing me this opportunity to share with them on this wonderful journey that they've got. Kia ora.